Hello again, this is LaZouche Custom here. Okay, a long, long, long time ago, I built a Ed Brown Special Forces 1911 pistol. That pistol unfortunately got defunct. I stripped down, the parts were needed elsewhere. But recently, due to a few spare parts becoming available, I thought I'd rebuild her again, just to see, you know, whether she'd carry on okay. As you can see, here she is. The original slide, sights and frame were all still available. The same with the single thumb safety, and of course the slide stop lever as well. Were all still available, still packaged away, ready to be used. The only thing that I couldn't reuse was the barrel bushing. Originally it had Brown written on there as per the real steel. I had it engraved, but that one's been cut down and used on my Massad Ayoub commander size pistol, so I didn't have that available. But other than that, the rest of it is all from the original Ed Brown gun project that I built all those years ago, or a few years ago. A few bits that I've added since are a steel 5.1 beavertail grip safety. That was in my spares box, so I thought I'd use that up. And a black 4.3 hammer, that was in my spares box. A checkered mag catch, that was in my spares box. But the rest of it, as I say, comes from the original gun when I built it. As I say, it was just stripped down and the parts were used elsewhere. But, as I say, it's been rebuilt. It's going to be used again this year, a little bit anyway, just to see how it goes. It may be loaned out, I'll see how it goes. As I say, I like the Special Forces pistol. The original Ed Brown, I think, is a brilliant, or a very clean-looking, smart gun. I really do like it. It's one of my favourites, other than Les Bayer's. So I thought I'd give it a go again, just see how well she does. She cycles okay, all the action is okay. When I originally built this particular gun, I had to spray paint the outer barrel, because there wasn't these silver MEU ones available, or Night Warrior ones available. The only problem is, now that I've fitted one, it looks good, yeah. But it should have Ed Brown 45 ACP, whatever it is, written on the barrel hood. But unfortunately, as I say, I can't do that to these silver ones, so it's just going to have to stay with the original writing on there. But doesn't detract from the overall look. It's still got Special Forces, as I say. This is the original slide. Still got the Special Forces logo written on the side. So, yeah, I'm not too worried with that. Anyway, so there you go. So this is just a little update, really, just to show you that some of my pistols do get reborn again, sort of phoenix-like from the flames. So there you go. So yeah, it's just going to be reused again, and I'll see how it goes from now on. But all of the parts in here actually come from a cheap Bell 1911 pistol, which were knocking about in my spares box for yonks. So I just couldn't be bothered to use them because they were really, really temperamental as to whether they would work or not. They were always having problems. But I stuck them all in this, thought, sod it, give it a go, see whether it works, and it works. So, I don't know why, it shouldn't do. There's no difference from the exterior. It's, you know, it's a standard sort of pistol look, but the internals on this, although they're from Bell, they seem to work this time, whereas in all the other projects I've tried to use those parts in, they've always been a real pain in the backside, but for some reason in this particular gun they want to work. So there you go. Anyway, hope you like the look. It's my own wood grips, by the way, red mahogany, that I had in my my spares box again, that I thought I'd use. As I say, haven't used it yet. It will get used most probably at the next game, and just see how it goes. Okay, so that's my updated Ed Brown Special Forces custom project. Thanks for watching, and bye for now.